morning, students, parents, and staff. We want to welcome you to our virtual Student Social Emotional Learning Academy this afternoon. My name is Emily Alegria, and with me, I have three of my colleagues, Esmeralda Hernandez, Diana Rodriguez, and Mr. Juan Garza. This afternoon, we will be talking about self-esteem. Our self-esteem is a very important topic, boys and girls. This is something that we need to always, always be mindful of how we feel about ourselves. Our learning objectives this afternoon are: this afternoon, we will be talking about the definition of self-esteem. I apologize, boys and girls. I think there's technical difficulties with the slides. But this afternoon, we will be talking about the definition of self-esteem. We're going to describe the differences between high self-esteem in kids, five ways to build your self-esteem, and then we're going to go into discussing what low self-esteem is, the signs of low self-esteem, and ways to improve your self-esteem. We're going to end our session today with a video and a short review. And to begin, we have Ms. Esmeralda Hernandez that will be explaining the definition of self-esteem.
Good afternoon, boys, girls, parents, and staff. Yes, we will continue with what is self-esteem? Self-esteem is the opinion we have about ourselves. It is, if you have a high self-esteem, you're gonna feel proud of who you are, what you look like, how you act. People with self-esteem, we have on this slide kids, but it's also adults. Adults with high self-esteem feel proud of what they can do and see the good things about themselves. They're always thinking positive, okay? And self-esteem is made up of all the experiences and relationships we've had in our lives. Everyone that we've met, we talked to through since we were babies all the way to whatever age you are right now, that you ever met has added or taken away from how we see ourselves. For example, when you were a baby, when you were born, your parents took care of you. They care for you. They loved you. All of that love and care will bring up a very good self-esteem in kids. And then when you started school, you met your teachers, you met new friends, and those friends and teachers affected your self-esteem. And for the most part, it's a positive. You get positive high self-esteem with all the love and care that you've had as you were growing up. Self-esteem can be changed at any age. Sometimes people might go through a time where they're having a lot of problems, issues, and their self-esteem goes a little bit down, but the good thing is that you can always do something to bring it up, okay? And now, basically, and in other words, self-esteem, guys, to make it easier to understand, is the picture we have of ourselves when we look at the mirror. And if Miss, if you could remove my picture so I can show them the kitten, the picture there of the kitten, please. If you see carefully, you have a kitten looking at himself in the mirror, and he sees a strong, ferocious lion. And what it says on the caption, it says, what matters most is how you see yourself, boys and girls. You know, it's how you see yourself. Sometimes people might not think that or might not think highly of you, but it is ultimately it's what you think about yourself. And so let's be like that little kitten looking in the mirror every morning and thinking we're strong. We can do everything, we're invincible. Thank you, let's go to the next slide. We continue with kids with high self-esteem don't worry about how others will judge them because they know who they are. They're not gonna feel insulted, you're not gonna hurt their feelings that much because they know who they are, they're strong people. Kids with high self-esteem also have the courage to express themselves. And for example, kids with high self-esteem will be able to give an opinion. If the teacher or the parent or a friend asks them about an opinion, his or her opinion, they're gonna be courageous enough to say how they feel about the situation. Or if this child needs help, he or she's going to be able to ask for help, because asking for help does not make you less of a person. You know, it just means that you want to learn, you want to get better, and that's what happens with a high self-esteem. You have that courage to ask, and you don't keep quiet. Kids with high self-esteem have an "I think I can" attitude. Okay, they're always thinking that they can do things, they're capable of doing things, and therefore they are inspired to set new challenges. They're willing to take a risk. They're willing to try a new game. They're willing to ask somebody to be their friend because they have an "I can" attitude. You know what? I'm a good person. I'm a good athlete. Then children with high self-esteem also are magnets to possible opportunities. Like I said, they will believe in themselves and they will be able to take risks, and they can plan for the future even more. Kids, and then as you can tell, everything connects as we go along. If they're able to take risks, well, they're going to set and achieve goals. They're not going to give up. They're going to keep trying until they achieve their goals. And last but not least, kids with high self-esteem accept themselves for who they are. You know, we all look different. We're unique, right? And that's good. So they accept themselves for who they are. And they accept their strengths and weaknesses. We all know we have strengths and we have weaknesses. So it is very important for all of us, whether you're a kid or an adult, to accept ourselves for those strengths and weaknesses. And if we can, we need to get better at certain things. Like in our weaknesses, we can practice to get better. And ultimately, what matters the most is that you love yourself for who you are. Okay. Next, we will have our colleague Juan Garza. He's going to continue with the topic of self-esteem.
Esmer, great job, by the way. Hello, boys and girls, students, parents. Great having you. Thank you for joining us today on this topic of self-esteem. I'm going to go ahead and cover 5 ways to build high self-esteem. Number 1, having a feeling of trust or safety. Who are some people that we trust? Mom, dad, our parents, our family, our friends. Knowing that we have these people in our lives allows us to improve our self-esteem. And number 2, knowing who you really are. It's important that we know who we are and that we love who we are. And that includes our personalities and some of our physical characteristics, such as short hair, long hair, being tall, being small, big ears, small ears, boys and girls. Love who you are and everything about yourself. Number 3, having a sense of belonging. We belong to our family, first of all, and that's the most important thing that we can have in our lives, family and loved ones. We also have a group of friends that we know we can count on. And that goes a long way in building our self-esteem. Number 4, having a feeling of purpose, direction, and responsibility. Being involved in different activities and having goals is a part of your self-esteem, as well as being responsible for different things, such as sports, practice, or even having a pet. You know, it's very important that you take care of your pets and that you feed them and provide them with love and nourishment, just like you would a sibling. And number 5, feeling like you are capable and successful in the things you do. Be proud of who you are, boys and girls, okay? Only you know the hard work that you put into what you've accomplished, okay? So make sure you always give yourself a pat on the back, even when you fall short. All right, we're going to go ahead and go on to the next slide. Now, this is totally opposite of what I just covered, okay? These are some symptoms that we see in kids with low self-esteem, okay? You may see some of these items in yourself, but the good news is that we can always work on and improve our self-esteem, guys. Okay. First bullet says, don't believe in them. Kids with low self-esteem don't believe in themselves. They doubt themselves. They feel inadequate. Second bullet, they see themselves as failing before they even begin. Kiddos, I don't know if you heard of a basketball player by the name of Michael Jordan, but he once said, you miss 100% of the shots you never take. So don't be afraid to try something new, okay? And even if you fail, make sure you give yourself credit for at least trying. A lot of people, they're afraid to try for the fear of failing. Next, kids with low self-esteem have a hard time forgiving their mistakes. I've known kids, including my own kids, that can be hard on themselves at times for not meeting their expectations or the expectations of others. And all too often, many kids with low self-esteem want to compare themselves to others. And that's not right, guys. Be happy and proud of who you are and what you've done, okay? Kids with low self-esteem believe they can never be as good as they should be or as good as others. Once again, you know, don't get into the habit of comparing yourself, okay? You don't know the work that someone else put into what they've accomplished, okay? And you can always use that as a motivating factor to work on your goals if you want to be better at something. Kids with low self-esteem are afraid to show their creativity, guys. And that comes with a fear of rejection, a fear of being ridiculed. Boys and girls, learn to not care what people say or think about you. Be who you are. Be different. Be creative and love that you're different. I don't think I would like to be like everyone else in this world. And I'm glad I'm different in many ways. And you should be too, guys. Kids with low self-esteem, some kids spend most of their time alone. Well, I know this year has been a tough year because of the pandemic, but during a regular school year, guys, we have so many students on all the campuses throughout our district that would love to be a friend, guys. Try to meet someone that has the same interests as you, that enjoys the things that you do, whether it's sports, cheerleading, video games, movies. Those are the type of friends that you want to meet and have. Kids with low self-esteem don't accept compliments. If your mom or dad says, mijo, you look so handsome, or mija, you're so pretty, or even if your teacher, and I know your teachers say it all the time, wow, you did a great job, congratulations. Accept it. Smile and say thank you. And lastly, kids with low self-esteem have an I can't do it attitude. Okay, guys? That alone is the beginning of failure when you tell yourself you can't do something, guys. A winner will always have the I can do it, I will do it attitude. Well, that is all for my part in this presentation. Next, I'm going to go ahead and turn it over to my colleague, Ms. Diana Rodriguez. Thank you, guys.
Hello, students. I'm very excited to be here this afternoon, and I'm going to be talking to you about signs of low self-esteem in kids. Some of the signs are cheats or lies when he or she believes he's going to lose the game or do poorly. Some of the students with low self-esteem would rather lie and say, oh, no, I won, or no, that person cheated, instead of saying, it's okay if I lost. It's okay if I didn't win this time. Because remember, practice makes success. They also put themselves down. They doubt themselves and are always apologizing. The mentality is, like Mr. Garza said, I can't do it. So I'm not going to be able to do it correctly. And this is very difficult. Why even try? So they keep putting those messages into their minds and they start self-doubting. They start putting themselves down, thinking that they can't do whatever it is that has been asked of them to do, whether it be academics, whether it be sports, whether it be extracurricular activities. They are easily influenced by peers. They're not leaders. They're more of the follower type. And if somebody says, let's do a mischief, let's do something that is going to be where it's going to hurt somebody's feelings, they're very easily influenced and they will go ahead and do it. And so they instead of showing that leadership skill of, no, I don't think that's the right thing to do, and that's not the best choice, they will follow what others tell them to do. And of course, there will be some consequences for that kind of behavior. They're afraid to learn new things or avoid challenges. And so with that, when they think of the, I can't do this, they don't even try to go to do something new. Many of us have our strengths and weaknesses. And so when we have our strengths and we're good at a certain subject like math or reading or writing, science, it's very easy for us to do. But in our weaknesses, it's a little bit more difficult. It's a little bit more challenging, but we strive to do our best. Well, students with low self-esteem don't even try. They avoid it. They don't want to do it. And so if your teacher asks you, come on, you can do it. Let's work on this problem. Right away, the student shuts down and tries to avoid it. They are unable to make choices or solve problems. They're not willing to make those choices on their own. They're always asking somebody else, you know, what do you think? What should we do? Like I said, they're influenced and they follow what others tell them to do. They avoid a task or challenge without even trying. They give up very easily. They quit soon after beginning a game or a task, and they give up at the first sign of frustration. So they don't even try. Our next slide. Here are a few steps you can take to improve your self-esteem. We want to feel good. We want to be successful. So these are some of the steps that we can take. You can focus on your positive characteristics. Like I said, we have strengths, and it could be a favorite subject. Let's say that you do very well in spelling and you join the spelling bee. And so you strive, you know, and always act on that positive characteristic to help you be more successful. So you focus on the things that you do well. And then those things that are more difficult for you, you keep on trying. You just don't give up and say, well, I can't do that. You change that mentality around and you say, well, it's a little bit difficult for me, but I'm going to try tutoring. Or I'm going to try to do a different strategy to do this. So it's always focusing on the positive. You have a good attitude. We wake up in the morning and it's our attitude that gears us to what kind of day we're going to have. So if we wake up with a positive attitude, our day is going to be on a positive note. I know that during the day, our attitude might change, and that is perfectly normal. Something can happen. We might get bad news, or we might get a low grade or something unexpected, and our attitude might change. But then again, we can always go back and say, okay, this happened to me, but it's not going to be forever or all the time. So I'm changing my attitude again to be positive about things. Get plenty of rest and exercise daily. When you rest, when you go to sleep early and you wake up refreshed the next day, your mind, your brain is better at thinking, at functioning. And also your body needs that daily exercise. So you can go outside to your backyard and run some laps or ride your bicycle. But all that brings a lot of good energy into your body. And so that helps you also be a good student, be a learning student here at school. Practice your talents. We all have talents and they're all different. I see our students at school. And I admire how some of our students have gotten first place in UIL or the choir. They have won awards for being in choir or the marathon or just so many talents that you all have. We have middle school students that come and they cheer and dance class. And so each one of you has a talent or talents, and those are the ones that need to practice. The more you practice, the better you get in doing those talents that you have. So practice them daily. Learn new things. It is very important to learn new things every day. Right now, a lot of the new learning things that everybody's learning, even myself, is technology. And so every day I learn something new. Every day you learn something new. You are at in a grade level, and next year you're going to be in a different grade level, and you're going to learn new things as you go to middle school, high school, college, your workplace. Every day is a learning day. So take those experiences with you and learn something new every day. Make and keep friends. It's very important. Those students with high self-esteem can make friends easily, and they can keep friends. Why? Because of who they are, how they feel about themselves. And they attract those students, those friends, to be with them because they're always so happy or excited. So learn to make and keep friends. Accept yourself for being you. There's no one in this world like you. You're unique. You have your own fingerprint. And so just with that, accept yourself and be excited and happy for who you are. Accept yourself for being you. Thank you. Next, we're going to have Miss Emily, and she's going to present or show us a video. And then she's going to review what we learned this afternoon.
Good afternoon again, boys and girls. We have this short video that's going to teach us all about how to be awesome being you. Let's pay attention. This is a great video, boys and girls.
How do you feel about yourself? I know, that's a weird question. And right now, you were asking, why are you asking me a weird question?
We're having a little bit of technical difficulties. We're going to restart the video, boys and girls. Give us a moment. Here it goes.
How do you feel about yourself? I know, that's a weird question. And right now, you were asking, why are you asking me a weird question? Let me tell you why.
Don't know why that's happening, boys and girls. But we'll try one more time. Let's see if it works.
How do you feel about yourself? I know, that's a weird question. And right now, you were asking, why are you asking me a weird question? Let me tell you why. Self-esteem. What? How we feel about ourselves. And what are five things you can do to feel awesome about being you? These are great questions. And on this episode of Rocket Kids, we explore those questions. I'm Vivian, and let's get this started. What is all this self-esteem stuff? Let me put it this way. When we have high self-esteem, we...
It seems like he keeps pausing at the same point, boys and girls. What the video is talking about, boys and girls, is about how we need to be always positive about our self-esteem. What this video really does is it recaps everything that our lovely counselors, Ms. Hernandez, Mr. Garza, and Ms. Rodriguez have just talked to us about. It defines a definition between a low self-esteem and a high self-esteem. And it tells us that we always need to be positive about ourselves to make and always believe that we are awesome being who we are. I think we're going to attempt maybe playing the video one more time. That's what I'm seeing.
You feel about yourself. I know, that's a weird question. And right now, you were asking, why are you asking me a weird question? Let me tell you why. Self-esteem. Self-what? Self of how we feel about ourselves. And what are five things you can do to feel awesome about being you? These are great questions. And on this episode of Rocket Kids, we explore those questions. I'm Vivian, and let's get this started. What is all this self-esteem stuff? Let me put it this way. When we have high self-esteem, we feel good about who we are. You are one super awesome person. We are proud of what we can do. I love the way you handled that. Giving myself a pat on the back. We believe that we can do it, even if we don't succeed at first, because this little bump in the road is just that, a bump. We can see our own good qualities and accept ourselves. Even if we make mistakes, because everybody makes mistakes. Everybody? Yep, everybody. When we have low self-esteem, it's like the exact opposite of that. In this zone, we may think we aren't as good as others. We may think about the times we don't succeed or make mistakes, rather than the time we do well. We may be hard on ourselves and give up easily. I know, this is kind of a sad zone to be in, but there is hope. There is that other zone, the backpatting zone. So let's go back there. Yeah, that feels so good. Here are five things we can do to have better self-esteem, or as I say, to feel awesome about being you. Number five, try your best. You can feel awesome about yourself when you give something a really, really good try. Do your best at whatever you do, and your self-esteem is sure to grow. Number four, pitch in. Do nice things that help others get things done. Like our parents, we can help with meals and keeping the house clean. We can get involved at school or volunteer in your community. Everybody needs a little help. Pitching in helps us realize that we can make a difference. Number three, turn that I can't into I can. When you are faced with something new, do you say to yourself, this is too hard, I'm not good at this? Change the way you think about trying new things, and instead say, I will give this a great try. I can handle this, and I can do it. Start saying, I can, and you will be amazed at how this will help grow your self-esteem. Number two, practice the things you do well. Practice, practice, practice. They say practice and patience makes perfect, and that's true. We have to keep doing the things we love to get better. And it takes time. Find a way to schedule time and practice. When we see our progress and become really great at something, our self-esteem becomes really great too. And number one on the list of five things you can do to feel awesome about who you are. Make a list of the stuff you are good at. Yeah, a list. It can be anything from drawing to dance. Maybe it's a sport or a hobby. It can be anything. If you're good at it, put it on the list. Sit down with your family and build this list together. It's fun. I like this one because it really helps us to think about the things we are good at. And that's where it all starts. What are things you do to build your self-esteem? What are you good at and what are you doing to get better? Let us know by commenting on this video. We would love to hear from you. Don't forget to follow, like, and subscribe to our channel so we can keep sharing great videos with you. Thanks for watching this episode of Rocket Kids. I'm Vivian, and remember to always be your best self.
Okay. I'm glad we got to show you that video, boys and girls, because it was just a great video. Now, let's do a little recap. Our next slide, please. To review everything that we covered today on self-esteem. Basically, boys and girls, I want you to remember these last tips right here. Your self-esteem comes from your life experiences, boys and girls. It's the way that you see yourself, because the way you see yourself affects everything that you do in life. Having a high self-esteem gives you a good feeling about yourself. And having a low self-esteem, well, it makes you keeps you from doing great things. And we don't want you to stop doing great things because you are great at everything that you do every single day. Remember that self-esteem is something that can change and it can improve at any age, whether you're a pre-K-er or a fifth grader, a middle school, high school, or even us as adults. Our self-esteem can change. We can improve our self-esteem and have a high self-esteem. Just remember this. Eleanor Roosevelt said, "No one can make you feel inferior without your consent." That's all we have for today, boys and girls. We do want to invite you to our next presentation in 2 weeks on April 29th. We will be presenting again on the topic of positive thinking. So we want to invite all of you to our next presentation, which will be Thursday, April 29th, again at 4 p.m. here on YouTube. And I hope to see you next time. Thank you everyone for joining us. We really appreciate your presence. Good evening, goodbye, and remember, have a